give my yes to you today. I choose.
Good morning. It's Tuesday, the 18th of June, and I hope you got a good cup of coffee. If you have your Bibles, turn to John 3, verse 36, Johannes 3, verse 36. It's the last verse in that awesome chapter in the Gospel that talks about, for God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish but will have eternal life. Now, right at the end, the last verse says, the one who believes in the Son has eternal life, but the one who does not obey the Son will not see life, but the wrath of God remains on him. It's such a powerful, such a compact, but such a full verse of scripture. Again, it comes down to a decision that we make. The one who believes in the Son has eternal life. It's a faith-based decision that is given to you and to me to decide, to weigh up the evidence, to look at the facts, to look at our lives, and then to say we need a Savior, and I believe that it is Jesus Christ, the Son of God. And then we have eternal life. And then interesting, it does a switch. It says, but the one who does not obey. You see, to believe is to align your life according to that truth, according to that North Star, to position Jesus Christ and what he demands, what he asks of us, what he, through his love in our lives, enables us to do, we need to be doing. We need to align. We need to make that faith decision brings about a life shift. And that's why many people that we work with, they say things, and yet we don't, in our gut, we just don't trust them because their life actions don't align to the truth of their words. And so, yeah, the old saying, the walk and the talk doesn't match up. It says, who does not obey the Son will not see life. But here comes the interesting thing. But the wrath of God remains on him. And because the wrath of God remains on him, they do not see life. When you and I accept Jesus Christ, bad things happen. Life still challenges us. Waves still roll over us, and winds still buffet us, and we go through storms, yet we see life in all the troubles, the tribulations, the difficulties. En al die moeilikheid van die samelewing, ons sien nog steeds die lewe. Die wat nie Jesus in hulle lewens het, sien nie lewe nie. Hulle, die lewe rol vir hulle. Daar's nie 'n standvastigheid, daar's nie 'n hoop, daar's nie 'n daar's net chaos in hulle lewens. En in hulle, en jy hoor dit in hulle woordeskat, jy hoor dit in hulle taal. Jy sien dit in hulle reaksies op dit wat met hulle gebeur. The one who believes in the Son has eternal life, but the one who does not obey the Son will not see life. But the wrath of God remains on him. As we go into this week, and yesterday was a public holiday, as we go into this week, I trust that you will see life because you have chosen life, that Jesus Christ is the Lord of your life, and that you walk in obedience to that truth. You shape your life along that decision, and people will be able to see it, your words will testify to it, and your life will mirror the life that God would have you live. And I know for a fact that one of the things is that you're supposed to drink coffee in this life. Not tea, man. But I trust you have a good, wonderful Tuesday. And that's just a dig at some friends. Have a wonderful Tuesday.